This is my sort of dream-themed tin. And here's what I have so far. It's very blue and very glittery and very different from the other tins that I've done so far. So this is pretty straightforward. Bottles filled with glittery things with stoppers made from beads that I've stuck a pin through and driven down into the corks. And I also did the same thing with this little skull bead, which got glitter all over it. And then it has a little beaded top to it. So I'm happy with this. I'm thinking that I'm going to do some silver stars on the batting up here. But you will notice that the outside is very different from the inside. I've got a very blue thing going on the inside, and there's a lot more color out here. There's a red heart, there's a yellow rose with red edges. So looking back and forth, I decided to make two additions to pull the outside of the tin into the inside. And that is, I'm going to add at least one red heart right here. Maybe also a couple of little ones up here. I don't know yet. And I pulled a yellow paper rose out of my stash and glittered it up along the edges. And I'm going to put that in here somewhere. Not quite sure yet. I probably need to trim it down a little bit because it's a little too tall to allow the tin to close. But somewhere, probably right there, I'm going to add that rose. And I also have room for maybe one more thing in here. I don't know. Might need one more thing. Maybe not. We'll see. So that's where I am so far. I need to get all this stuff glued in and also apply the glossy finish to the inside of the lid. I'm just about finished filling this, and I'm just gonna let it sit and dry overnight because it's a little humid here today, and this glossy sealer is still a little tacky. I went ahead and added some stars and hearts to this little bit of fluff, and added a leaf to go with the rose. One of the weird little laws that I've learned along the way is always put greenery with flowers because it makes them look more realistic, and it makes them look like what they are, which is something that is from a plant and not just some sort of weird wadded up piece of paper that's been stuffed down in there. So I always try to put leaves in whenever I do flowers. And this is another thing that I'm going to add. It's a piece of tracing paper that I've torn off. And I'm going to fold it up and stuff it down into this horrible empty spot right here. It's empty because it's curved, so I couldn't put the bottle over there. And my option was to do something narrow like this, which I didn't like because it ended up smooshing down my clouds up here. So I'm just going to fold a piece of paper. And so that this won't be blank, I just wrote a little note on it that says, "A dream is a wish that your heart makes," which is in keeping with the theme of the shrine. And I'm just going to fold that up and stuff it in there. And sometimes I fold and then refold. Like, I think maybe this. And then this. And then this. And that sort of fits in there pretty well. So, just kind of bend it so that it curves a little bit along the side. And then put a little glue in this fold right here. And a little glue along the side. And pull off the little threads of glue that always appear. And then I'm just going to press it down in there. And sometimes it's easier to use a skewer or a paintbrush to move things around than it is to use your finger. And then I always try to wrinkle the edges of the paper to make it a little more dimensional and a little more interesting. So nobody will ever see that little note that I wrote, but I know it's in there. So, and a lot of the shrines that I make have those little hidden messages in them. I kind of like doing that.